All right, Webster Tarpley is going to be with us for the balance of the show today to talk about several issues. We're going to get into what's happening with the economy, the controlled implosion. We're also going to talk about Barack Obama's supporters in law enforcement, no longer peace officers, saying, you basically criticized Barack Obama, we're going to arrest you. Got a clip of that coming up in a moment. And I know we also have quite a few callers that are patiently holding. We'll also be taking your calls coming up in the next hour. You're welcome to hold till then or call back later. There's another Bloomberg story here. Hundreds of economists urge Congress not to take a rush on rescue plan. We also have former Nobel Prize winner for economics, Joseph Stiglitz, who exposed that this was a orchestrated plan when he left the IMF and World Bank in 2002. I interviewed him again about a week and a half ago. I interviewed Ron Paul earlier this week. Bailout failure will cause U.S. crash. So we have all these top economists saying it's a fraud, it's a scam, it's theft, it's making a new branch of government. It's literally letting the private banks become government, but then they will use governmental power to shut down other financial institutions. So this is pure fascism. And what does both political parties do? There are polls. A week ago, Rasmussen and others, Zogby, had polls of 28% to 30% for the bailout. Now we have polls that came out in the last 2 days as low as 5%. I have two different polls here that show 9%. And I'm sure you've seen those polls, too. They've been all over the news. The point is 9% support it, but magically almost every politician does. And they got Nancy Pelosi, and they've got Paulson, and they got Bush, and they've got Barack Obama and John McCain and Sarah Palin and all of them up there agreeing that, oh, we've got to have this or a depression's going to hit. And then all these headlines like this today, bailout failure will cause U.S. crash. The U.S. stock market could suffer a devastating crash with shares losing a third of their value this week if Hank Paulson's financial bailout plan fails. U.S. Treasury officials have warned. And so, meanwhile, there's wheels within wheels here. They did a $940 billion payout this week. That's Reuters. $940 billion out of the Treasury. Just made up, put on our backs, devaluing the currency. You think on average 15% inflation this year. It was 10% last year. Now it's about 15. Most economists I talked to say it'll be about 20 to 30% next year. Compounded each year. Oh, what's that going to do to people on fixed incomes? Or anybody for that matter? And so remember when you think inflation's been bad now with fuel and food and how? No, no, no. Wait until you get 20% compounded, not just 10 or 15. So all of this is going on, but the biggest issue here is that even in the newest version, even in the latest version, they are talking about making the Federal Reserve, basically, and private bankers, the controllers of the Treasury, and then this small group of less than a dozen families that own the Federal Reserve, they control the federal regulators, they go out and take over whoever they want, they act as government, they have a letter of mark. Well, they're already doing that, just like they already spied on us without warrants, and then went back and got the liability protection, the pardons. So there's just so many facets to this, but I just want to remind you, you're talking about $700 billion, it's really $5 trillion. And then in the last week, it was $940 billion, and they passed over a $1 trillion defense budget Friday. So understand, ladies and gentlemen, they're also faking the liquidity crisis. The big banks are taking the money, because only select banks are being given this, the $940-something billion. And they got more than that in the last year and a half before that. They take that money, and then they ban shorting against themselves, as Webster talks about. They ban predatory action against themselves, but then attack the real economy, manufacturing, you know, retail, the service economy. Then they're attacking that and taking that over right now. This is a vicious, militarized takeover. Webster Tarpley, I want to spend the 3 or 4 minutes in this segment first because you're a top scholar. Going through your bio, it's long. You've written books on the economy, papers on it. You predicted all of this. You're also an expert on Obama, and I want to get into that. But first, in this abbreviated segment we have left with you, then we'll come back with the Barack Obama. I wanted you to, I've thrown out in the last 3 or 4 minutes a few of the points I'm looking at here, but just simplifying it for people, what are they witnessing right now with this mass looting?
Well, it is, of course, a world economic depression of unimaginable proportions. It is not controlled by anybody. There is no oligarchical banking group anywhere in the world that has any of this under control.
But they are, well, let me stop you, but they are engineering more stealing. I agree it's out of control, but they are stealing.
They're responding opportunistically at various phases of the crash to try to direct it against others. But this is a genuine, authentic world economic breakdown crisis. It is the collapse of the Anglo-American system, the post-1945 dollar-based imperialist system. And above all, at the center of that, it is the crisis of the derivatives. We're told that this is a bailout of mortgages. That is a big lie.
Yes.
If the government were getting mortgages, they would have then income flows or houses. If there were no income flows, that would be much less serious. It would be bad.
But hey, all the bad mortgages could have been paid off for less than $100 billion. That is admitted. So why are we talking about trillions
because
and trillions? Because they sold junk.
One quadrillion, 1,000 trillion to 1.5 quadrillion of derivatives, and that is what's being bailed out. Now, you're very right to point out that this is monstrous, it's elitist, it's oligarchical, it's unconstitutional, it's criminal, and all this other stuff. Let me just focus on the other point. It's futile. You cannot prop up collapsing paper values in a panic. And the $700 billion, even though that seems like a very large sum, that is chump change. That is peanuts compared to the needs of financing this crash. The crash is inexorable. The crash is unstoppable. There is no way to prop these things up.
Yes, and they know that. They know it ends in the end of the dollar. My point is, Webster, $940 billion was shelled out last week, and the public doesn't even know. It's buried in Reuters and AP. Meanwhile, the public's talking about revolting over $700 billion, and as you said, they're blaming the public for this on subprime mortgages, and it has nothing to do with it.
Right, it's the reactionary myth that has been spun out is that poor people, blacks and Hispanics, bought mortgages for homes that they couldn't afford, they defaulted, and now they've brought down the system. This is absolutely insane. Just looking around the world, today we have Fortis Bank, which is a very large bank in Belgium, which is blowing up. We've got Bradford and Bingley, which is the second largest mortgage bank in the United Kingdom.
We had WaMu, the biggest bank in world history, to go under, went under 3 days ago.
We had Washington Mutual. We also have HBOS Bank, another very large British mortgage.
And 2 weeks ago, we had Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac.
Okay, so it's an authentic world economic depression. Now, your basic choices are three, and let me stress this. The first is the hyperinflationary bailout that you're seeing right now, which is what Goldman Sachs is demanding through Paulson, with the help of Pelosi and Reid and Obama. The Democratic Party is, by and large, the principal party of Wall Street and the bailout.
And the real economy gets nothing.
Absolutely.
But we fit the bill for all of it.
The three possibilities.
Yeah.
The first one is the hyperinflationary bailout. That's what you have to stop now. Any person of goodwill has to say no, 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 1,000 times no. However, if that's all you do, you get the second possibility, which is the deflationary crash. And people who just say no to the bailout, go back to the free market, unfortunately, that will get you into chain reaction bankruptcies of the large money center banks. It will lead to a general banking panic and a deflationary crash on the model of 1930, 31, 32.
But with a stagflation overlay, you're still going to have the Weimar Republic type printing press stuff.
Well, the printing press is the hyperinflationary one, so that would be number one.
Yeah, but you can have the two together.
Yeah, you might have that too. You might have a hyperinflationary depression. That's certainly a possibility. But I think just to simplify it, either the hyperinflationary bailout, which ends in failure, of course, or the deflationary one. The third one is obvious the thing to do. Return to the New Deal. Return to the tested, tried and true, absolutely proven and track-tested remedies of the New Deal.
All right, Webster, stay there. We're going to come back and let you get into that, and then Barack Obama. But to be clear, again, this is socialism for the bankers or socialism for the people. And the reason it's the lesser of two evils is it would build the real economy, which instead the bankers are collapsing what's left of the real economy to finance and fund themselves. All right, we got the Barack Obama stuff coming up. Talk bad about Barack Obama. Go to jail. We're not kidding. Infowars.com.